Oh, I didn't get my other side of my head. Okay, good afternoon, future compañeros and compañeras. I'm sorry that I'm very busy because of my so many professional commitment. No? I always lectured in the MCLE for almost every day, no? And also we have so many cases, and that I was also charged as the editor-in-chief of Nicapil News TV, radio, and print media. No? I need to say that I'm also an editor-in-chief of a television, and radio, and a newspaper. So my topic today is because of the persistent public demand, they want me to lecture on Katarungang Pambarangay Law. No? So, the Katarungang, I have written a book on Katarungang Pambarangay Law, no? Wherein it is almost 600 pages, 2021 edition. And that, this is the only book that the President of the Republic of the Philippines gave greetings, no? And likewise, the DILG Secretary Anyo also endorsed this book, no? To all barangays and barangay officials, no? And I always lectured in this topic, Katarungang Pambarangay Law. And that in the history of the Philippines, there is no such thing as an author that the one who gave the message is the President of the Republic of the Philippines. So I have so many books, no? I have also a book on the Dangerous Drugs Act and a book on legal ethics. Next month I will release my book on remedial law, no? Volume 1 remedial law, no? I will volume 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then I will also release my book on political law, international law, that includes international criminal court because of this ongoing investigation of the prosecutor of ICC, wherein they want to investigate Duterte about this drug killings, no? And that is why I probably I'll be the first author who will have a book on international criminal court. No? At present, there is no author on international criminal court. So probably I will include it in my political law, international law, and international criminal court. No? I will discuss it extensively in my book. No? So my topic today is about Katarungang Pambarangay Law. This is part of alternative dispute resolution. So why? Because the primordial purpose of the Katarungang Pambarangay Law is to reduce the number of court litigation and prevent the quality of justice which had been brought about the indiscriminate piling of cases in courts. You know, I was a former MTC judge for 7 years. When I was a judge in Cainta, Rizal, I have 10,000 cases. No? I said 1,000 cases to 1,500 cases a day. When I was promoted at Metropolitan Trial Court in Taguig City, I have 15,000 cases. I set cases 2,000 to 2,500. No? Can you imagine that? How a judge can perform his task wherein they are flooded with so many cases because of the Katarungan Pambarelo, it will reduce the number of cases to be filed in court. That is why it is considered as an alternative dispute resolution. I will give you some nuggets of wisdom wherein I also include that in my book, no? Nuggets of wisdom, no? So the first nugget of wisdom is the late great president Abraham Lincoln, no? Who was also a vampire hunter, no? Abraham Lincoln, while studying law, was a storekeeper, but during night time he is a vampire hunter, hunting the vampires. Have you watched the movie of the late President Abraham Lincoln? A very, very nice movie. When he was elected as the President of the United States of America, he delivered his first federal State of the Nation address. And he said, "Discourage litigation. Inform your neighbors that in litigation, there are no real winners. All are losers in fees, expenses, and waste of time." Can you imagine that? Huh? When he delivered his first federal State of the Nation address, the great American lawyer who became the great American president delivered his speech, "Discourage litigation. Inform your neighbors that in litigation, there are no real winners. All are losers in fees, expenses, and waste of time." Wow, a very, very nice nuggets of wisdom of the late President Abraham Lincoln. Likewise, the Chief Justice of the Federal Supreme Court, Warren Burger, when he was appointed as the Chief Justice in the U.S. Federal Supreme Court, he delivered his State of Judiciary address. He addressed it to the judges, to the prosecutors, to the law professors. And he said that lawyers, judges, prosecutors, law teachers are mesmerized with court contests or drama. But they fail to know that we are healers of justice. No? Can you imagine that? The Chief Justice of the U.S. Federal Supreme Court delivered his State of Judiciary address to all the judges, justices, lawyers, prosecutors, law professors in the U.S. And he said that lawyers, judges, prosecutors, law teachers are mesmerized by this court drama. But we must know that we are healers of justice, no? That is why there is what they call katarungang pambarangay law, in order that parties will settle the case amicably within the barangay. But the most important is the first sermon of our the Son of God. In the Bible, Jesus Christ was mentioned as Son of Man and Son of God. Why Son of Man? Jesus Christ was mentioned 300 times, more than 300 times that he's a Son of Man, and also a Son of God. Why? Because Jesus Christ is a human being, no? Jesus Christ, I was able to prove that the Bible is correct, no? It was already proven that Jesus Christ is a man, at the same time, Son of God. Why? You know, when Ronnie White dig in Israel, he was able to find the lost ark, no? We call it the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant is the earthly throne of God, no? He will go down to the Ark of the Covenant, and he will sit there, no? It is a pillars of lightning, no? It is a pillars of lightning. God, because you cannot see God, you will die, no? There's a pillars of lightning, and it was Ronnie Wyatt discovered it. and there was a blood in the mercy seat. The mercy seat is a the mercy seat is the right side of the ark of the covenant, and there was blood, and the blood of Jesus Christ. No, when Jesus Christ was crucified when he was crucified in the Calvary, there was a great earthquake. No, when the great earthquake, it broke down the mountain, no, and the rocks, no, and the blood of Jesus Christ flowed down. No, then it fall on the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant. So Ronnie Wyatt brought the blood, and he went to the most sophisticated medical laboratory in Israel, and that he asked them, after all the doctors, the scientists were discussing, they said that this is a human blood. A human blood, and the blood is a living blood. Can you imagine that? It is not a dead blood, a living blood. No? And that they were discussing, because in this blood, there are only 24 chromosomes. No? Because all of us have 46 chromosomes. No? 23 from our mother and 23 from our father. That is why we have, all of us, human beings, have 46 chromosomes, but Jesus Christ have only 24 chromosomes, 23 chromosomes from his mother, Mary, and a male chromosome coming from God. So he is really a son of God, a human being at the same time, God, no? Jesus Christ, no? So we know that when Jesus Christ delivered his Sermon of the Mount, the first sermon of Jesus Christ, when the 12 disciples saw that there are so many multitudes of people wanted to listen to the sermon of Jesus Christ, they climbed on the Mount Olive. No? This feeling of olives, there is an S, no? But silent S, Mount Olive. And Jesus Christ delivered his first sermon, and he said, "Blessed are the pure in heart, because they can see God. Blessed are the poor, because they can enter the kingdom of God. Blessed are the merciful, because they can receive mercy." But our subject is Katarungan Pambarangaylo, and in verse 9, he said, Jesus Christ said, "Blessed are the peacemaker. They shall be called the children of God." So if you are a peacemaker, mediator, conciliator, or you are a member of the pangkat, tatapakasundo, or lupong tagpamayapa in the katorong pamarayan, then you will be called as children of God. And Jesus Christ said, "In my Father's house, there are so many mansions." No? So if you are a children of God, your mansion will be waiting there in heaven. No? If you want to read the Bible, chapter 5, verse 9, no? The Sermon of God. "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God." Likewise, Judge Henry Moses, no? Of Grossman of the U.S. Federal District Court, no? And he said that 4 out of 5 potential litigants will settle their case amicably if you will insist that they will reconcile and mediate, no? So can you imagine that, no? Instead, 4 out of 5 litigants will settle their case amicably if you will insist that they will settle it amicably through mediation, conciliation, or mediation. You know, in my book, aside from there is a message from the president, of all authors in the Philippines, I'm the only author that the president of the Republic of the Philippines gave a message. Also, the ILG secretary. No? So there are no other authors of the book wherein the president, the ILG secretary, gave their message. This is Jesus Christ, our God, Son of God. Then this is Abraham Lincoln, when he said that, discourage litigation. Inform your neighbors to compromise wherever you can. In litigation, there are no real winners. All are losers in peace, expenses, and waste of time. This is the great American lawyer who became the great American president. This is Chief Justice Warren Burger, now of the U.S. Federal Supreme Court. And the last one is the message of Senator Thomas Jefferson. This is Thomas Jefferson, that I include it in my book. According to Thomas Jefferson, educate the people, the mass of the people, and through education, they will know democracy and the truth will set them free. So a very nice message of the great senator of the U.S. Senate, Thomas Jefferson. All of those nuggets of wisdom, I incorporated that in my book, almost 600 pages. This is you know, if you go to the bookstore, if you go to the bookstore, there are no other books on Katarungan Pambari. I'm the only author on Katarungan Pambari Law. And that I already made more than 2 million profit on my book on Katarungan Pambari Law. The latest is Municipality of Taytay Rizal, both 50 books of Katarungan Pambarangay and 50 books of A Guide in Dangerous Drugs. But the city of Makati purchased 2,000 books. No? Makati purchased 2,000 books. City of Mandaluyong, 2,000 also. City of San Juan, 2,000 books. And Quezon City, 5,000 books, no? So probably I have now my own bookstore, no? I call it Palo Bookstore, no? Pampilo and Associates Law Offices Bookstore, no? It is now registered, no? I have now a bookstore, no? I will compete with Rex Bookstore, Central Bookstore. There is now a National Bookstore. There is now Palo Bookstore. That is my bookstore. Okay, so that is Katarungan Pambarangay Law. The primordial objectives of the Katarungan Pambarangay rules is to reduce the number of court litigation and prevent deterioration of the quality of justice which have been brought about the indiscriminate filing of cases in courts. To attain this objective, Section 412, Paragraph A of Republic Act 7160 requires that the parties will go first to a conciliation process before the Lupon Chairman. The Lupon Chairman is the Punong Barangay. And that the Punong Barangay have 15 days to settle the case amicably. You cannot file a complaint in court, either civil or criminal, and even to the prosecutor office or other government offices if there is no certificate to file action. It is required by law that there must be a barangay reconciliation because it is mandated under the law. So if the barangay captain or punong barangay could not settle it within this period, then it will be forwarded to the Lupong Tagapamayapa. The Lupong Tagapamayapa, there are 10 to 20 members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa, and that the complainant and the respondent will choose among the 10 to 20 members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa, and they will choose three. No, one will be chosen by the complainant, the second will be chosen by the respondent, and the third one by them. If they could not settle, who will be the three members of the pangkat at pangsundo, then it is will be drawn by lot, no? So that is the procedure. And that the pangkat at pangsundo have only 15 days to settle the case. So 15 days from the barangay captain, 15 days from the lupon apangkat pagka sundo, then they can ask additional 15 days, no? So that is 45 days. Then of meritorious cases, they can ask additional 15 days, no? So the maximum of 60 days. Why? Why the maximum is 60 days? Because the running of the prescriptive period is only good for 60 days, no? So the if you file a case in the barangay, automatically the prescriptive period of the crime will stop, and that the barangay official and the pangkat pagsundo and lupot ng pamayapa, they have 60 days to settle a case. Then after that, it will start the running of the prescriptive period. So the entire arbitration law is governed by the combined provisions of the arbitration law, that this is Republic Act 863, the Civil Code, the Rules of Court, the Consumer's Code, and the Labor Code, the Corporation Code, and other even the Supreme Court decision. So in this case, NPC, National Power Corporation versus RTC Branch 2 of Iligan City, there was a question whether or not this law is constitutional, whether or not this law, the arbitration law, is constitutional, whether it is valid, and whether it is legal. The Supreme Court ruled in this case, NPC versus City, the RTC Branch 2 of Iligan City. The Supreme Court ruled, yes, it is constitutional, it is valid, and legal. So remember the case of NPC versus RTC. No? The law on arbitration designed to offer procedures for the speedy disposition of civil cases such as contracts, agreement, accident cases, medical practice, and so on and so forth. So meaning to say that through arbitration law, through mediation, through reconciliation, then it will speedily dispose the case handled by no need to go to court, no? As according to the late American president, discourage litigation. In litigation, there are no real winners, all are losers. In peace, magbabayad ka ng abogado. Litigation spaces, no? And waste of time. Sayang oras mo, no? You will go to court. It's very tedious case, no? So remember the case of NPC versus RTC Branch 2 of Iligan City, no? National Steel Corporation versus Rizal Terrell Court of Plano del Norte, 304 Iskra, page 595. So it is now clear that our law on arbitration was declared by the Supreme Court as constitutional, no? So meaning to say it is valid, and that it is legal. That is why there is now a alternative dispute resolution, wherein before you will file your case in court, then you have to first have a barangay reconciliation before the punong barangay, no? Okay, I will now discuss some of cases of the Supreme Court, no, that involves Okay, this is the case of Judge Maximo Contreras, Branch 61 of MTC, no? Metropolitan Court of Makati, no? In this case, Felicidad Uy filed a motion to dismiss on the ground that there was no barangay reconciliation. So this the respondent filed a motion to dismiss on the ground that there was no a barangay reconciliation, praying to the court that criminal cases number 145233 and 145234 for a slight physical illness will be dismissed because there was no a barangay reconciliation mandated under the Katarungang Pambarangay Law, Republic Act 7160, amending Presidential Decree number 1508. So, Judge Contreras denied the motion to dismiss and proceeded the hearing. So, the lawyer of Felicidad Uy appealed it directly to the Supreme Court. Can you imagine that, no? The lawyer appealed it directly to the Supreme Court instead of appealing it to the RTC under certiorari rule 65. Can you do that? You know, in this case, the Supreme Court relaxed our rules of court. So in this case, Felicidad Uy versus Judge Contreras, the Supreme Court took cognizance of this case despite the fact that there was no barangay reconciliation. So the Supreme Court took cognizance that despite the fact that the lawyer did not follow the doctrine of hierarchy of courts. I mean to say that if you lost your case in the MTC, your next appeal will be RTC. Then from RTC to the Court of Appeals, then from the Court of Appeals to the Supreme Court, this is the doctrine of hierarchy of the courts. No? But the lawyer of Felicidad Uy did not follow the doctrine of hierarchy of the courts. Filed it directly to the Supreme Court. No? If you still remember your remedial law, no? Particularly civil procedure, no? If you lost your appeal, if you lost your case in the MTC, you can appeal it Rule 40. So appeal from MTC to RTC Rule 40. If you lost your case in the RTC, then you can appeal it to the Court of Appeals via Rule 41 and Rule 42. What is Rule 41 and Rule 42? Rule 41 is the RTC exclusive original jurisdiction. And Rule 42 is review by appeal, no? This is our appellate jurisdiction. Because RTC have different kinds of jurisdiction. We have concurrent original jurisdiction. We have original jurisdiction. We have exclusive original jurisdiction. And we have appellate jurisdiction. So Rule 41 and 42. Then Rule 65, mixed question of law and question of facts. Then Rule 45, purely question of law to the Supreme Court. In this case, the Supreme Court told that while it is true that this court, meant to say the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeals, and the original trial court have concurrent original jurisdiction on writs of certiorari, prohibition, mandamus, quo warranto, and habeas corpus, such concurrence does not accord litigants unrestrained freedom of choice of the court to which application they may direct them. Meaning to say, the Supreme Court, nanirma na Supreme Court, and according to the Supreme Court, to the lawyers, you are not given a blanket authority to what court you will appeal. You must follow the doctrine of hierarchy of the courts. But in this case, the Supreme Court relaxed our rules of court and took cognizance of the case. Why? According to the Supreme Court, why it took cognizance and relaxed our rules of court? Because of its importance. Because of the passage of Republic Act 7160, we call it the Local Government Code, amending Presidential Decree number 1508 or we call it di Katarungang Pambarangay Law. And that the Supreme Court took this as. In this case, the Supreme Court said that there is a hierarchy of the courts, determinative of the venue of appeals, which also served as a general determinant of the proper forum for the application of the writ, that is certiorari, you know, and that the lawyers party should follow, no, the hierarchy of the courts. But in this case, the Supreme Court took cognizance, no, and that in this case, the Supreme Court reversed Judge Contreras and reversing his decision. And the Supreme Court dismissed the case on the ground that there was no barangay reconciliation. So remember the case of Felicidad Uy versus Judge Contreras. Furthermore, the Supreme Court before closing these cases, according to the Supreme Court, the Supreme Court wishes to emphasize the vital role which the revised Katarungang Pambarangay Law plays in the delivery of justice. A very nice wisdom of the Supreme Court at the barangay level in promoting, number one, peace, stability, progress, and effectively, this is the most important wisdom of the Supreme Court, and effectively preventing, reducing expensive and wearisome litigation. Yes, that is why, according to the late, the great Abraham Lincoln, the president of the U.S., discourage litigation. Inform your neighbor that in litigation, there are no real winners, all are losers in peace, expenses, and waste of time. Wow, a very nice wisdom of the president of the United States of America, Abraham Lincoln, to effectively preventing and reducing a very expensive and wearisome litigation. That is the case of Felicidad Uy versus Judge Contreras, GR number 11416, September 26, 1994, decision of the Supreme Court. Parties to the dispute cognizable by the Lupon, that is Lupon taga Pamayapa, should sincerely exhaust administrative remedies provided by law, no, with due diligence, and that the court should not hesitate, us judges, no, we are not, according to the Supreme Court, court should not hesitate to impose sanctions, no, to discipline the lawyers and parties in not going to the barangay for a barangay reconciliation. That is the case of Felicidad Uy versus Judge Contreras, GR number 111416. That is the best decision of the Supreme Court. We now proceed with Lupong Taga Pamayapa. So, you know, this is very, very important, the Lupong Taga Pamayapa. In every barangay, there is what we call Lupong Taga Pamayapa. Section 399 of the Katarungang Pambarangay Law, wherein I discuss it extensively in my book, that in every barangay, there is what we call a Lupong Taga Pamayapa, and that the chairman of the Lupong Taga Pamayapa is the barangay captain, no? Barangay chairman, no? And that there are 10 to 20 members of the Lupong Taga Pamayapa, and that they have 3 years term, no? So every time that a barangay captain elected, then the barangay captain will organize a Lupong Taga Pamayapa, no? The barangay captain automatically is the chairman of the Lupong Taga Pamayapa, and that the term of office of the 10 to 20 members of the Lupong Tagpamayapa is 3 years na after the constitution. So, what are the qualifications in order that you will become a member of the Lupong Tagpamayapa? Number one, any person actually residing, no? So, if you reside in the barangay, then you are qualified to become a member of the Lupong Tagpamayapa. Second, if you work there, no? Although you are not a resident in that barangay, but you work there, for instance, you are a professor, or you are a janitor, or you are a guard in that school, or a private company, then you can also become, you are also qualified to become a member of the Lupong Tagpamayapa. Provided that you are not disqualified by law, and that, what are the qualifications? You must possess integrity, impartiality, independence of mind, sense of fairness, reputation of probity. Then you can be appointed as a member of Lupong Tagpamayapa. That is from 10 to 20. So, what are the qualifications? Number one, you are a resident of barangay. Number two, you work in that barangay. Number three, you are not disqualified by law. Number four, you possess integrity. Kailangan may integridad ka. Impartiality, independence of mind, sense of fairness, and that you have a reputation of probity. Those are the qualification in order that you will become a member of Lupong Tagpamayapa. Then, a notice will be posted, no? The proposed membership of the Lupon will be posted in 3 conspicuous places in the barangay, no? Section C, a notice to constitute Lupon shall include the names, no, of the proposed members who express their willingness to serve shall be prepared by the punong barangay, no? The barangay captain mag-prepare, no? The punong barangay within his first 15 days in office, no? And that it will be posted in 3 conspicuous places continuously for a period of 3 weeks. So, it is the punong barangay or barangay captains who will be the one to propose the name of the supposed members of the Lupong Tagpamayapa, that is from 10 to 20, as long as they are qualified, no? Sinabi ko ng qualification, no? They are qualified and they are willing to serve. Then, it will be posted in 3 conspicuous places. Karamihan dyan, sa simbahan, talipapa, and in barangay or in waiting shed, no? It will be for 3 consecutive weeks. Why? What is the purpose why it must be posted in the 3 conspicuous places? In order to inform the public, in order to inform the residents of the barangay who are the proposed membership in the rosters of the Lupong Tagpamayapa, and that they can file a petition, a motion, or they can object, no? I mean to say that nakita na nila yung kaaway nila, no? Not qualified. They can object. Hindi qualified yan, kapitan. He is a barumbado, so on so forth, no? The residents can oppose, no? Can object the qualification. And they can also recommend, no? Yes, magaling yan. Yes, he's good. So, that is the purpose why it will be posted in 3 conspicuous places. The punong barangay, taking into, so if there are opposition, if there are comment or objection to the proposed membership of the Lupong Tagpamayapa, that is from 10 to 20, anong gagawin ng kapitan? If there are oppositions, there are disqualification. This is the law. The punong barangay or the barangay captains taking into consideration any opposition, objection to the proposed appointment or an or any recommendation, ha? Mayroong opposition, objection, mayroon ding recommendation. The barangay captain or the punong barangay will choose among them, no? Within 10 days. And that the barangay captain or punong barangay will appoint them, no? In writing. So it must be in writing. In my book, in Katarungan Pambarelo, because in my book there is a Q&A. It is a user friendly, no? Q&A. You know, in there are so many lawyers in when I lectured in IBP Ilocos Norte in Lawag, there are so many lawyers who brought book, no? Lima ano ang binili nila dahil yan order nila i-donate sa mga barangay captains, no? In Bigan, I also lectured, bumili din sila. Also in Baguio, no? When I lectured in Baguio, in IBP Baguio, ang tawag nila, hindi Baguio ang IBP na doon, yung maraming bumili ng libro doon, no? So, Q&A ito, question, ang ginawa ko sa libro ko, question, answer, law, then decision of the Supreme Court. Question, answer, and my question, can punong barangay appoint a member of the Lupong Tagapamayapa orally? Answer, no. It must be in writing. Okay. Second question in my book. Who will sign the appointments of all the members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa? Answer, punong barangay and attested by the barangay secretary. No? You know, when I lectured in IBP Lawag, IBP Bigan, IBP Baguio, IBP Cebu, no? IBP Ormoc, IBP Davao, IBP Cebu, I was flooded with so many questions, no? Lahat ng abogado nagtatanong. One other questions. Lawyers they want to test the mental capacity and prowess of the lecturers. In fact, I have so many co-lecturers that failed because the lawyers, the judges, the prosecutors, the law professors are not exempted. They are my students, no? So lahat ng law professors niyo, my students, no? They have to undergo my training, no? Judges, my students, justices, my students, no? Lahat na, kinuha ko na, no? Lahat ay law deans are my students, no? They have to undergo my training, no? So, they will insult you, no? If you are an expert, no? They will insult lecturers, no? They will insult, not only they will laugh, no? Tatapagtawanan ka. And that, they will say, lecturer, your lecture is wrong. Can you imagine that? And they will plank you. And the Supreme Court will never allow you to lecture anymore. No? I have so many co-lecturers, more than 50 of them, were no longer allowed by the Supreme Court to lecture. That is why I told them, if you are given the chance by the Supreme Court, by the IBP to lecture, MCLE, do your best. If not, you will be insulted. You will plank. And you will be never again allowed to lecture. No? So, one lawyer asked me, Judge, are lawyers absolutely not allowed to appear in a barangay reconciliation? I said, yes, it is absolute. Then he said, how about judge, no? How about, you know, he tested me, no? How about judge that I'm armed with a special power of attorney authorizing me to appear in a barangay reconciliation, in a barangay dispute before the punong barangay and the Lupong Tagapamayapa? I'm allowed? I said, no. But I'm armed with a special power of attorney authorizing me. My answer, no. I said, So, inisulto ko rin siya. Sabi ko, you know, Panyero, you circumvent our law. You circumvent our law because it is absolute. You are not allowed to appear. Even you are armed with a special power of attorney. And I cited a case of the Guzman versus Senator Puyat. I said to him, you know, my mentor is Justice Amorpina Herrera. She was the one who hired me as a lecturer of Philippine Judicial Academy. Philippine Judicial Academy is a school of the Supreme Court, a school of judges. I teach judges. I teach justices. I only not teach law professors, no? But reviewers, no? All, even justices, judges, no? Because I'm a lecturer of the Supreme Court, Philippine Judicial Academy. I said, no. You circumvent the law. I cited the case of the Guzman versus, I said, my mentor, Justice Amorpina Herrera, the first woman who topped the bar, number one, the first woman who graduated summa cum laude University of the Philippines, the first woman who became editor-in-chief of the Philippine Collegian. He is my mentor. He was the one who penned the decision. You circumvent the law. The best lawyers in town, prosecutors, judges, always ask me questions. No? But I said, anything under the sun, I can answer them. But my co-lecturers, ninginig, so there are so many judges. So my co-lecturers, I beg, but they're scared. No? Me, no. You know, when I lectured in IBP Tacloban, somebody said, I'm Justice of the Supreme Court. Oh, wow, very good, Justice. How are you? This is my question, Judge. Oh, no. Okay, no problem. Even you are a Justice of the Supreme Court, I will answer your question. And that, you know, I'm not bragging. Every time that I lectured judges, justices, prosecutors, lawyers, law professors, law deans, they gave me a standing ovation. And my grade is excellent in all my lectures. So, no bragging yan, no bragging. But, yes, they always gave me a standing ovation and an excellent grade remarks. So, that is katarungan pambargay lo, no? I saw a comment from your administrator, no, that do not insult the lecturer because they help us, no. But I message Rose that that is part of the game, no, being a lecturer. You will be insulted. And but me, I'm very willing to answer them. I'm very willing, no? Because I'm an expert. No? I'm an authority. I'm an authority. Any question, even outside my topic, I can answer it. Even you are a justice of the Supreme Court, even you are a justice of the Court of Appeals, no, never mind. If you are number one in the bar, I can answer it. No? So then the list of appointed members of the Lupung Tagpamayapa will be posted in the conspicuous places in the barangay for the entire duration of their term of office. So, what is their term of office? 3 years, no? So, it will be posted for the entire duration, that is 3 years, in 3 conspicuous places in the barangay, no? Then, next, how about if in the barangay, majority are members of indigenous community? Like me, I'm from Zamboanga. No? I'm from Zamboanga. Sa Zamboanga, there are so many indigenous tribes, tawag ng tribal, communities. Tausug. There are so many Tausug there. Yakan. No? There are also some Maranao and Subanen. But majority is Subanen tribe and Tausug. Tausug daw. So, what will happen if, how they will settle the case, their barangay disputes? Under the law, if in the barangay where the majority of the inhabitants are members of the indigenous cultural communities, then the local system of settling disputes through their councils of datus, no? May tinatawag kasi kami doon na datus, no? Council of datus or council of elders shall be recognized, no? So the councils of datus, the council of elders, are the one who will Bernal from Zamboanga, from Pagida City. So part of Zamboanga Peninsula, there are so many thousands, but majority sa inyo atas Pagadian, Maranao, no? So it will be settled by councils of elders or datus, no? Wherever it is applicable. So remember those future compañeros and compañeras. So we'll now proceed with the oath and term of office, no? So upon appointment, so it is the barangay captains, or it is the barangay chairman or punong barangay will be the one to issue a written appointment, no? So after the 10 to 20 appointed members of the Lupung Tagapamayapa, so in my book, can the barangay captain appoint 9 or more than 20? The answer is no. The law says 10 to 20. So in my book, there is a question here that can a barangay chairman or purong barangay appoint 9 or 25? The answer is no. It must be between 10 to 20. No? 10 to 20. So, once there is already a written appointment, all of the members of the Lupung Tagapamayapa will take their oath before the punong barangay. So, manunumpa sila before the punong barangay. Then they shall hold office until a new lupon is constituted in the third year following their appointment. Meaning to say that until and unless there is now a new set of membership of the Lupung Tagapamayapa, then they can have a holdover. We call it holdover capacity. Holdover capacity. So, they can still be a member of the Lupon even beyond the 3 years period if there is no yet a new set of Lupong Taga Pamayapa. Or what will happen if some of the members of the Lupong Taga Pamayapa dies or resign or transfer for or bedridden, no? Sick. So what will happen, no? Then the punong barangay will appoint in the replacement of those who resigned, who died, transfer of work or residence, but the term of office is only the remaining term. For instance, nakapag-serve ng 2 years, isang taon na lang, no? So that is not unless sooner terminated by resignation, transfer of residence, or place of work, or withdrawal of appointment by the punong barangay with the concurrence of the majority of the members of the Lupung Taga. Okay, I'm sorry, there was a internet connectivity problem, no? I saw it there is a holdover capacity, no? In my book, I said, what is some of the members died, resign, transfer of residence, what will be the term of office? He said the remaining term of those who resign or those who transferred residence. Now, so future compañeros, compañeras, and there are also, I saw some lawyers attending this lecture. You can if you want, you can buy my book through online. So that is out of office and term of office. So should a vacancy occur in the lupong tagapamayapa or any cause, like transfer of residence, sickness, or died, then the purong barangay shall appoint a qualified person who shall hold office only for the unexpired, remember, future compañeros, unexpired portion of their term, as long as they're qualified. Ano ba yung mga qualification? I discuss it. Ang qualification, kailangan he or she is a resident of that barangay. Or he or she employed of the barangay. Then third, not disqualified by law. Fourth, must have a proven, mayroong probity, sense of fairness, and that a good reputation. Those are the qualification in order that you will become a members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa and Pangkatan Tapakasundo. I know that some of you attending this lecture are also members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa or Pangkat ng Tagapagkasundo. So remember those future compañeros, compañeras, that the qualifications in order that you will become a member of the Lupong Tagapamayapa. Now, I will discuss the functions of the lupon. So, the functions of the lupon, number one, exercise administrative supervision over consolation panels. The consolation panels are the pangkat ng tagapagkasundo. No? So, the Lupong Tagapamayapa 10 to 20 will exercise supervision over conciliation panels, that is pangkat ng tagapagkasundo. Tatlo yan. Three membership. So they are the one who will exercise supervision over pangkat ng tagapagka. Then, second, they will meet regularly. No? So in my book, in Katarungan Pambarelos, there is a question here. Why the members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa will meet regularly? Answer. In order that the members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa will share to one another their observations, their experiences, and their techniques and techniques in how to settle the case amicably, how to dispose the case amicably. No? So, in my book, I discuss it extensively. So, the entire membership of the Lupong Tagapamayapa must meet regularly at least once a month. Pwedeng dalawa, tatlo. At least once a month to provide a forum for matters relevant to the amicable settlement of disputes. No? And to enable various conciliation panel members to share with one another their observation, experiences in effecting a speedy resolution of disputes. So that's why, no? In my case, I said that when I lectured before the Liga ng Mga Barangay in Taguig, Liga ng Mga Barangay in Cainta, and in Manila, I said that you better meet regularly in order that you can share your observation, you can share your experiences in handling barangay dispute, no? So that is the purpose there, no? So that they can share it, they can advise their colleagues how to settle the case amicably. In one of my lectures, I think it is IBP Cebu, no? You know, IBP Cebu, they always ask questions on Katarungan Pambarangay. No? They always ask questions about why they are not allowed to appear as a lawyer. No? I said, it is absolute, you are not allowed. They asked me, sir, what is the best qualification in order that there is an effective lupo ta kamaya pa pangkat ng tagapagkasundo. I said a variety of people, no? Kailangan mo yung pulis para manakot. Oh, kung hindi ka makipagkareglo, talo ka sa kaso. Kailangan mo dyan, pare, please, please, sit in the case of it, please. Oh, anan, no? So, a variety of personalities, eh, in order that we can, because the primordial purpose in the Katarong Pabarelo is to settle the case amicably. That is their functions under the Katarungang Pambarangay Law, no? To give justice within the barangay and to unclog dockets in courts, no? Because without that alternative dispute resolution, the Katarungang Pambarangay Law, we are flooded with so many cases. Before a case will be filed in court, then there must be first a barangay reconciliation. Then, next one, what are the other functions of the Lupong Tagapamayapa? Exercise as other powers and perform as other duties and functions as may be prescribed by law or ordinance. I will give you an example. They will exercise as other powers and perform as other duties and functions as may be provided by law. Number one, IETF, no? Yung health protocol. So, they can arrest, they can detain people who are violating the health protocol, like the curfew hours, no? They can set up checkpoints, no? In order not to allow anybody to go inside or go outside if the barangay is under restrictive quarantine, because there are so many people who are COVID patient, no? So that is why they are they can exercise other functions, no? Also, they can arrest people who are noisy or who are quarreling during night time, no? So those are the powers and functions allowed by law to the members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa. Then we proceed to Secretary of the Lupo, no? So the barangay, in my book I said that automatically if you are appointed as barangay secretary, automatically the barangay secretary will become the secretary of Lupong Tagapamayapa, no? That is why very busy ang barangay secretary, because not only that he or she is secretary of the barangay, he's also a secretary of the Lupong Tagapamayapa. Not only that, under the Katarungang Pambarangay Law, all barangay secretary are mandated by law to report to the municipal courts or city courts, no? Lahat ng MTC, no? They will report whatever the result of the disputes. They will report it to the judge. MTC, hindi artisya, to the judge. They are also the custodian of all the records, no? Of whatever proceedings in the barangay, no? So the barangay secretary shall concurrently serve as the secretary of the Lupon. He shall record the result of the mediation proceedings before the punong barangay and shall submit thereof to the proper city or municipal courts. So, one of his or her function is to record all the results of the mediation. Then, he will submit a report to the proper city or municipal courts, no? Mag-submit siya ng report doon sa amin when I was an MTC judge, no? Then, shall also receive and keep the records of all the proceedings submitted to him or to her by various conciliation panels. So, very, very busy talaga ang barangay secretary, because he will record all the mediation results and proceedings before the punong barangay and the Lupong Tagapamayapa, submit a report to the respective courts, no? MTC, no? Pag city, ang tawag natin dito ay Municipal Tri-Court and Cities. Pag Metro Manila, ang tawag namin sa MTC is Metropolitan Trial Court. Kapag Municipality, Municipal Trial Court. Pag Power Plant Municipality, Municipal Circuit Trial Court. So, the Secretary is very busy. He will, she will report to the court, to the barangay, and that also records of all the proceedings and keep all the documents. Then the Lupo Secretary shall also issue a certified true copy of any document as long as it is not confidential. So some lawyers, lawyers in Lawag City and in Biga, no? Because they are also flooded with so many questions by their barangay captains or officials. Sabi sa akin, Judge, records ba sa barangay reconciliation is confidential? Can we use it as an evidence against the parties? I said no, it is confidential, because I told the lawyers that the purpose of the barangay reconciliation is to settle the case amicably, no? in order to unplug the dockets of the court, no? So in order that it will unplug the dockets of the court. Can you imagine that? When I was an MTC judge in Taguig, I have 15,000 active cases. When I was an MTC judge in Cainta, I have 10,000 cases. I said cases 2,000, no? 2,000 cases a day. How can I finish it, no? So that is why it's very, very important to implement and to execute the Katarungam Pambarangay Law. And that, you know, there are so many lawyers wanted to test my capacity, no? Because they always ask me, why Judge Pampilo lectured judges? Why Judge Pampilo lectured prosecutors? Why Judge Pampilo lectured law deans, law professors, all members of the legal community? Is he a number one in bar? Is he a summa cum laude? Is Judge Pampilo a Harvard graduate, Yale graduate? I said, I'm a graduate of nowhere, but I am an expert. So you must listen, because I am the lecturer of the Supreme Court. So I lectured even judges and justices. So all your professors, law professors, are my students. They have to undergo my training. I teach them how to become an effective law professor. So that is the law, no? Wherein it is confidential in nature. Then, what happened if there will be a vacancy in the pangkat ng tagapakasundo, no? Yung lupong tagapamayapa is 10 to 20. Yung pangkat, tatlo to, no? The complainants and the respondents will choose 3 among the 10 to 20 rosters membership of the lupong tagapamayapa. So, yung tatlo, yung pangkat ng tagapakasundo. For instance, namatay yung isa o isa nagkasakit. So, what is the law? What is the procedure in order that the membership of the pangkat will be added? Because it must be 3. Why 3? Bakit kailangan AB number? 2 will prevail over 1. No? So, kailangan 3. Hindi pwede 4. Pag 4 kasi, 2, tabla. No? Kailangan 3. 3. No? Any vacancy in the pangkat shall be chosen by the parties to the dispute from among the other lupon members. So, if there are vacancy, it will be chosen from among other membership in the lupong taga pamayapa. So, the party fails to agree. Kung hindi sila makapag-agree, what will happen? Then, the vacancy will be filled by drawn by lot. Mayroong bote ang barangay captain, ilagay yung pangalan ng mga membership of the Lupon, then i-allog, then choose one. No? So, any vacancy in the pangkat shall be chosen by the parties to the dispute from among other Lupon members. So, the party fails to agree on a common choice, the vacancy shall be filled by lot, drawn by lot by the Lupon chairman. So, remember that, compañeros, compañeras, drawn by lot. Another question asked by the lawyers in Leyte, no? In Leyte, kasi parang siyan, they also asked me, so I'm bombarded with so many questions about Katarumo Pambarelo. They said, judge, what happened if the parties assaulted a member of the Lupong Tagapamayapa or pangkat ng Tapakasundo? Can he assault or box or mow? I said, no. And another question, what will be the penalty? So, because of those questions, that because I lectured the entire Philippines, I even lectured in New York, you know, future compañeros, compañeras, no bragging, I lectured in New York, in US, in California, no, I lectured, I go there, no? Meron sana akong pupuntahan, mag-lecture sa Europe, eh. So that lawyers from Europe, Filipino lawyers, will no longer go to the Philippines. But because of the online, pwede na sila, no? We call it synchronous MCLE lecture. So in my book, I discuss that once you assaulted a members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa or Pangkat na Tapasundo, then you can be charged of direct assault penalized under the revised penal code. I said that the Lupon members, while in the performance of their official duties, or on occasion thereof, shall be deemed as persons in authority as defined by the revised penal code. And I discussed a case that I handled when I was a judge in MDC judge in Rizal. A former municipal administrator was charged in the barangay. So he attended. Nagkainitan. So, because according to him, bias yung some of the members of the Lupon. So, he assaulted the members of the Lupon. The members of the Lupon filed a case against him for direct assault. So, I heard the case. And that after more than a year of hearing, I convicted him of direct assault because in my decision, I said that the members of the Lupon are considered persons in authority while in the performance of their official duties or on occasion thereof as defined by the revised penal code. But the penalty is not more than 6 years. So he applied. The convicted accused, a former municipal administrator, filed a petition to avail of the probation. Because the penalty that I impose is only not more than 6 years now. You are under the probation law, kapag hindi lumampas ng 6 years, you can avail of the probation law, hindi ka na makulong. So, in that case, he applied. But the office of the probation wrote me a letter that under the law on probation, the following are not entitled to the probation law. Number one, if you are convicted of direct assault, you are not allowed to avail of the probation. If you are convicted of a crime against national security, like treason, probation law is not applicable. If you are convicted of the a criminal violation of our election code, no? Then you are not qualified. So that was the question. You know, in Rizal, politicized masyado, no? So, dalawang congressman, limang mayor sa kabila, yung governor, vice governor sa kabila, limang congressman, isa, dalawang congressman, governor. So, both sides, no? Then I was in the middle of the warring politicians in Rizal, no? So I wrote again to the head of the probation office what it will be the, my decision whether or not to grant him the allowed him to be under the probation law. So in this case, the administrator, pinakahit talaga, sabi niya, it is a sea of the discretion of the judge because of that legal opinion of the administrator of the probation office, I granted him the probation. Hindi siya nakulong, no? So, it is a sea of the discretion of the judge. So, natapos ang kaso. So, yung kabila, nagalit sa akin, but I have to decide the case, no? That is, so do not assault, do not attack, do not maul any members of the Lupong Taga Pamayapa. Okay, we will now proceed. Benyo is different from jurisdiction. So when I was an MDC judge in Cainta, also in Taguig, also in Morong and in Cardona, I encountered so many all barangay captains naging kaibigan ko. They always ask me illegal questions. Sabi, judge, it is in Cainta, yung factory umusok ng itim, hazardous. And that the barangay, and that the residents in my barangay filed a case against the company. Do I have jurisdiction? I said no. Because this is an abatement of a nuisance. I said, Kapitan, this is an abatement of a nuisance. You have no jurisdiction. Okay, we discuss now venue and jurisdiction. Disputes between persons actually residing in the same barangay shall be brought for amicable settlement before the lupon of said barangay. So, the venue, even in my book, I discuss it extensively that persons actually residing in the same barangay shall be brought for amicable settlement before the lupon of said barangay, no? Not other barangay. Second, those involving actual residents of different barangays within the same city or municipality shall be brought in the barangay where the respondent or any of the respondent actually resides at the election of the complainant. So, if there are two to three or more respondents, what will be the venue? The venue will be the actual residents. If they are resided in different barangays but the same municipality or city, then the complainant can file it in any of the residence barangay of the respondent. Pero sabi ko, bakit mo ipile doon sa Lupon, Tagapamayapa or barangay where the respondent resides? Eh, baluwarte niya yun. You better file it in your barangay. Now, why file it to the barangay of the respondents? No? So, that is why, no? That is venue. Venue is different of jurisdiction. If there is a question of law or a question of venue, in my book, I discuss it. In my book, in Katarong Paparelo, in my book, if there are questions of law, if there are questions of venue, who will give legal opinion? The one who will give legal opinion is the if it is a city legal officer. If it is a municipal legal officer, or even a prosecutor. They are the one who are under the law authorized to give legal opinion, no? And even on Benyo. So, if you have a case in the barangay and there is a question of law, then you can ask illegal, that question will be answered by the, not the judge, no? When I was a judge in Cainta, they always visited me, the barangay officials. Nagtanong sa akin, judge, Bausi, no? Nagsuntukan yung mag-asawa, judge, Bausi. Meron ba kaming jurisdiction? I said, yes, but not Lupong Tagapamaya pa, because in each barangay, there is what I call Bausi unit, no? Because if you would be charged of the violence against women and children, even you own that house, you cannot enter. And that it is the barangay, the wife or the husband can file it in the barangay, no? Kaya nga, in every barangay, aside from Badak, Barangay Anti-Drug Abuse Council, aside from Lupong Tagapamayapa, ang pagkatapagsunod, there is also Bausi unit. But di Lupon, walang jurisdiction, no? Because it is outsider jurisdiction. I will discuss later on what are the cases that the Lupong Tagapamayapa or pangkatap ng tapakasundo have jurisdiction. No? Bausi, another unit in the barangay. No? So that is then how about dispute that involves real property or any interest therein? Who have venue? All disputes involving real property or any interest therein shall be brought in the barangay where the real property or larger portion thereof is situated. So, if it involves real property or any interest thereon, ang venue niyan, where the property is located. Kung saan yung barangay, where the property is located, yan ang may jurisdiction. Okay, what are the cases that involves real property or interest therein? So, pag real property, it is a real action. I already lectured to you, remedial law, no? I discussed action in rem or real action, no? So you must file it in the regional trial court where the property is located, because it is a action in rem or real action. Okay. There are four kinds, no? Forcible entry and unlawful detainer. It involves real property. So, forcible entry and unlawful detainer. You must file it in the barangay where the property is located. Forcible entry and unlawful detainer. Another one, action publiciana. What is an action? I discussed it when I lectured to you, remedial. Action publiciana, it is an action to recover possession of real property. So doon mo ipapile where the real property is located. The third one, action reinvindicatoria. Action reinvindicatoria is an action to recover real ownership, no? So remember, no? In all disputes involving real property or any interest therein shall be brought in the barangay where the real property or a larger portion thereof is situated or located. So, forcible entry, unlawful detainer, action publiciana, action reinvindicatoria. So, remember, future compañeros, compañeras, I know that in your barangay, your neighbors will ask you questions about cases that were filed in the barangay, especially in real property or any interest therein, like forcible entry, unlawful detainer, action publiciana, and action reinvindicatoria. It must be in the place or barangay where the real property is located or situated. So, remember that, future compañeros, compañeras, action reinvindicatoria, action, pag sinabi action reinvindicatoria, recovery of ownership, action publiciana, This is an action to recover position. Then, forcible entry, no? From the very beginning, there is no legal right, no? Then, unlawful detainer. Remember that. Those cases, the barangay have jurisdiction. Forcible entry, unlawful detainer, action publiciana, and action reinvindicatoria. So, very clear na, compañeros and compañeras, about real properties wherein the barangay, the lupong tagapamayapa, pangkat na tapasundo, have jurisdiction to hear and settle the case. You know, if you are a member of the, you know, some of you are members of the lupong tagapamayapa and pangkat na tapasundo, you are considered as persons in authority as defined under the revised penal code. Then, we will now proceed with another topic. How about if the parties involved are not resident of the barangay, but they are working there? For instance, San Miguel Corporation in Barangay so-and-so, or another corporation, or they are college professor, or staff, nag-away sila, nagbatuhan, nagsuntukan. Meron bang jurisdiction ng barangay? The answer is yes. No? Those are cases arising from in the workplace, no? Where the contending parties are employed or at the institution, pasyon ng institution, mga eskwilahan ito, no? Where such party are enrolled for study, shall be brought in the barangay where the workplace or institution is located. So, if the dispute arise in the workplace where the contending parties were employed or they are studying, the parties are enrolled or studying, then it can be brought in that workplace, in that institution, in that school where the workplace or the school or institution is located. So remember that, compañeros, compañeras, no? Kung nag-arise yung demandahan dahil sa kanilang workplace, or nag-aral sila, or they are employees there, then it must be brought in the barangay where the workplace or institution is located. Remember those, compañeros, future compañeros and compañeras. Okay, how about if there is an objection? No? There is now an objection on the menu. Hindi pwede dyan, dapat dito sa kapila. So, who will decide? No? And if there are question of law, you know, there are so many barangay officials and member of the Lupong Tagapamayapa, even murder cases, they handle. Homicide. Okay. So, if there are objections raised during the mediation, who will decide it and who will give the legal opinion? Okay. Any objection to venue raised in the mediation proceedings before the punong barangay shall be deemed waived, no? So, before you will raise your objection, dapat doon mismo sa punong barangay, sa barangay captain, no? Because if you not raise your objection before the punong barangay or barangay captains, it is deemed waived. How about legal questions? Any legal question resolving objections to venue herein may be referred to and submitted to the designated secretary or his duly authorized representative. No? But in my book, I said, who can give legal opinion if there are legal questions to be arise? I will give you an example. Like me, no? Like me, when I was a judge in Taguig, MTC judge, Pumunta sa akin yung barangay captain, kaibigan ko. Sabi niya, Judge, yung mag-asawa, pinayagan ko magkahiwalay. No? Then they sign an agreement that they will be separated at pwede na sila mag-asawa. And we sign it. Is it valid? I said, no. Kapitan, you can be charged for gross ignorance of the law. No? It is against moral, it is against law, and it is against public policy. You cannot sign an agreement between the husband and wife that they can be separated and they can remarry each other. Hindi pwede yan. They must file first a case in court for annulment of marriage. Wala kang karapatan dyan, kapitan. So, if there are legal questions to be will be raised, who will give a legal opinion? No? City legal officer, municipal legal officer, then prosecutor, provincial attorneys, no? Municipal attorneys, they can give legal opinion, no? They can give, not judge, no? But me, although I'm a judge, I still give legal opinion, but I told them, nako, it can be, they can inhibit me because I know already the case, but that is why, as much possible, I do not want to give legal advice to the barangay officials who are my friends or to the members of the Lupong Tagapamayapa who are also my neighbors or my friends. So remember, future compañeros, compañeras, if your neighbors will ask questions and there is a legal question, then you inform them that they must go to the city legal officer, municipal legal officer, or a prosecutor or a municipal attorney because they are allowed under the law on katarungan pambarae law to give legal advice, not to the judge. Remember that, future compañeros and compañeras. So, as I've said, the great American lawyer who became the great American judge when he delivered his state of federal address, who is also a vampire hunter, the late President of the United States of America, Abraham Lincoln, when he delivered this state of federal address, discourage litigation. Inform your neighbors that in litigation, there are no real winners. All are losers in fees, expenses, and waste of time. Wow, very nice nuggets of wisdom. That is why there must be a barangay reconciliation. Discourage litigation. Inform your neighbors that in litigation, there are no real winners. All are losers in fees, expenses, and ways of time. Wow, a very nice nuggets of wisdom of a vampire hunter, the late Abraham Lincoln, the president of the United States of America. We will now proceed with procedure for an amicable settlement. What are the procedures in an amicable settlement? No? And who can initiate cases? No? Section 410 of the Katarungan Pambarangay Law. No? By the way, my book is already 3,000. No? 3,000. And that I'm very very happy that the liga ng mga barangay in Makati talk to one of my lawyers that they will buy 2,000 copies, no, of books, no. So 2,000 copies, so if it's 2,000, that is 3 million, 6 million, no, 6 million. Then sanuhan ganun din dalong libo in liga ng mga barangay sa Quezon City 5,000 no? So 5,000 is 15 million no? So umaagos ang pera ko because of my book no? And aside from that my book in dangerous you know of all lawyers you know there are so many lawyers judges prosecutors who bought my book on because they are drug court no? And power lawyers and I was amazed by their remarks and they said that of all the books in Dangerous Drugs Act the best book is Judge Pampilo because it is user friendly question answer decision of Supreme Court question answer law decision and yes that is why so many big law offices bought my books. They include it in their library. No? We will now proceed with procedure for an amicable settlement. You know, I have written also a book on legal and judicial ethics. No? Of all my books that I have written, ito lang yung I was only able to sell it 11 copies lang. Lahat ng abogado ayaw buksan, no? They do not want to open it, no? Natatakot sila. Ay, nakatakot dyan! Nakatakot! No? So, in this book, I incorporated more than 400 cases, no? So, ay, nakatakot! Ayoko! So, but you, being a bar reviewist, who will take the bar, it will help a lot, no? There are so many questions in the bar that you can answer it with my book, no? Legal ethics. Okay, so procedure for amicable settlement. Who may initiate proceedings? Upon payment of the appropriate filing fee, no? So may bayad dyan, no? Before, 500. Sa Metro Manila, 1,000 na ang filing fee, no? Tumaas, no? Upon payment of the appropriate filing fee, that is from 500 to 1,000, any individual who has a cause of action against another individual involving any matter within the authority of the lupon may complain orally or in writing to the lupon chairman of the barangay. So, once you pay the filing fee, then you can file a case against any individual, any matter that the barangay have jurisdiction. Saan mo ipapile? Either orally or in writing to the punong barangay. Nakalagay kasi ito, to the lupon chairman. Ang lupon chairman is the barangay captains. Automatically, kapag ikaw ay punong barangay or barangay captains, you are the chairman of the Lupong Taga Pamayapa. So, in my book, there is a question whether or not the barangay officials will reject your complaint if you file it orally. The answer is no. Because you can file a complaint in the barangay either orally, pwede verbal, oral. Punta ka lang, Kapitan, inaway ako. You can go there. No? You know, I'm the editor-in-chief of Nicopil TV News. No? It is a registered of DTI. When I was on board for giving legal advice about Katarungan Pambarangay Law, there were, I was flooded with so many questions. I will give you the one question na sabi niya, Judge, my question is, tinutol yung puno ng sanga ng santol ko, ng kapitbahay ko. Nagalit ako. Can I file a case against him? And what will be the case that I will file in the barangay? I said, yes, you can file a case against your neighbor. And the case will be malicious mischief. I said, malicious mischief. another one, no? Yung isa naman napakaganda, no? Sinabihan siya ng kapitan niya, ang pangit mo, ang babaho na pekpek mo, sabi niya, putangin na mo, sabi niya, then babaho ng pepe mo. So sabi niya, then he posted it in the social media, and he asked me, can I go to the barangay? I said yes. That is a case of grave oral defamation. The barangay have jurisdiction. How about, sabi niya, how about yung sa cellphone, sa text message, sa FB? I said that is a cyber libel. The penalty of cyber libel is higher than the penalty of libel under the revised penal code. And I told that the caller that the barangay officials, the Lupong Tagapamayapa, and Pangkat Tantapasundo have no jurisdiction on cyber libel, but on oral defamation, whether it is simple or grave, the barangay officials, the Lupong Tagapamayapa, and Pangkat Tantapasundo have jurisdiction. Another unique na tinanong ako kapon, you know, you better listen to my TV broadcast, no? Television, no? 9 to 10. Another one, ang tanong, sabi niya, what is, can I file a case against my neighbor whose dog is always barking? Nabulaho kami, grabe, hindi kami makatulog. I really wanted to kill the dog. Sabi ko, can I file a case? Sabi ko, yes, you can file a case before the barangay against the dog. Sabi ko, no, not the dog. Sabi niya, pwede ko bang sampahan ng demanda yung dog? Sabi ko, not the dog, the owner. Loko-loko yun. Sabi ko, yes, you can file a case against the owner of the dog. Dahil nabulao ka, hindi ka makatulog. Sabi niya. Okay, then, what will be my case? Anong judge, what is the case that I will file? May aso, sabi ko, unjust vexation. That is a case of unjust vexation. Nabulaho ka, naasar ka, nainis ka dahil sa ingay ng aso. It is a case of unjust vexation. Can I kill the dog? No. You cannot kill the dog, or you cannot hurt the dog, because there will be a case to be filed against you for animal cruelty. There is now a law on animal cruelty. So, compañeros, remember that upon filing of the payment, you can file a case in the Punong Barangay or Lupong Tagapamayapa Chairman. That is the Punong Barangay or Barangay Chairman. Orally, no? Orally or in writing. So, it can be orally or in writing. So, remember that, compañeros. Then, once you file the case to the barangay captains or the chairman of the Lupong Tagapamayapa, pag sinabi kasi chairman of the Lupong Tagapamayapa, automatically yan yung Punong Barangay. The barangay chairman, the Punong Barangay will, upon receipt, within the next working day, will summon the respondent, the complainants, and their witnesses to appear before the barangay captain or Punong Barangay for mediation of their conflicting interest. So, immediately, no? The next working day, the barangay captain can summons, magpapatawag, is summons under the local government code, same with the summons under the rules of court. Answer is no. Iba ito, summons. Pagpapatawag. No? They can also issue subpoena, no? To appear in court, to appear in the barangay for mediation. And that, the barangay captain have only 15 days to settle. Remember, if there are questions to be asked by your neighbors, your relatives, no, about barangay dispute, you inform them that the barangay have only the barangay chairman or or punong barangay have only a maximum period of 15 days to settle the case amicably. If he cannot settle it within 15 days period, then the barangay captain will refer the case to the Lupong Tagapamayapa. That is the membership of the Lupong Tagapamayapa is 10 to 20, you know. The barangay chairman, the punong barangay will constitute a pangkat ng tagapagkasundo, no? So, ang barangay captain, remember, 15 days lang siya, ang maximum niya, if nothing happen, then refer it to the Lupong Tagapamayapa and that the parties will choose 3 members for the pangkat ng tagapagkasundo. One will be chosen by the complainant, the other one will be chosen by the respondent, and the third one will be chosen both of them, no? But if they could not agree on the third membership drawn by lot, may bote, nandun yung names of all the members of the Lupon, tapos alugin, then they will get it, no? So remember those compañeros and compañero. So once the case is filed in the Lupon or barangay chairman, the prescriptive period of all offenses and crimes will be suspended for 60 days. Remember, future compañeros, compañeras, 60 days. While the dispute is under mediation, conciliation, arbitration, prescriptive periods for offenses and any cause of action under existing laws shall be interrupted upon filing of the complaint with the punong barangay. The prescriptive periods shall resume only upon the receipt of the complainant and respondent of the certificate to file action or certificate of repudiation, and that the interruption will not exceed 60 days from filing of the complaint, either orally, diba sabi ko, pwede orally or in writing to the punong barangay. So, this is now the procedure. Once you file a case, either orally or in writing before the barangay chairman or punong barangay, automatically, the prescriptive period will be stopped, will be suspended. Maximum is only 60 days. The barangay captain have only 15 days to settle the case amicably. Pag hindi niya masettle, automatically refer it to the Lupong Tagapamayapa and constitute 3 membership of the pangkat ng tagapagkasundo. Then pangkat ng tagapagkasundo have 15 days to resolve, no? So 15 days kay kapitan, 15 days ang pangkat ng tagapagkasundo, that's 30 days. Then, if they cannot settle the case amicably, hindi pa rin natapos, they can ask for additional 15 days, yung pangkat ng pagsundo, because the barangay captain, maximum 15 days lang. So, nagkaroon na siya ng 45 days. No? 15 days kay barangay captain, kay punong barangay, 30 days na sa pangkat ng pagsundo, hindi pa rin sila hindi pa rin nasettle. No? May 45 days na. In meritorious cases, last extension of 15 days. So, the maximum is 60 days. No? So, the maximum is 60 days. Why 60 days? Because of the suspension of the prescriptive period is only 60 days. No? You know, lawyers in Baguio, when I lectured, also in Bigan and in Lawag, sabi ng mga abogado sa akin Judge, I'm a barangay captain. Sabi niya, I'm a barangay captain. In my barangay, we are under quarantine. So, quarantine kami. and we are not allowed to have a hearing on our lupong tagapamayapa. What will happen, no? Wisdom lawyer ito. What will happen to the suspension? Sabi ko, yes, it is extended. Why? It is considered as fortuitous event, act of God. So, it is a fortuitous event. So, the suspension of the running of the prescriptive period of the princess is still applicable. Remember that. Is still applicable. Another question. Talagang, Judge, I'm a barangay captain. I'm a barangay captain. At the same time, I'm the president of ng Association of Barangay Captain. That is why I'm already also a counselor. Okay. A case was filed against me. Because according to the to my kababayan, I'm a bias. Where they can file a case? I said, they can file a case against you in barangay bureau. You know, in Manila, we have barangay bureau. So, is the barangay bureau have jurisdiction? I said, yes. Can they impose penalty? No. Who have authority to impose the suspension of the barangay officials, barangay captains? I said, you better buy my book. It is the municipal or city council, no? So, city or municipal council. Another question. Somebody also filed a case against me in the Barangay Affairs of DILG, Department of Interior and Local Government. Is the DILG have jurisdiction? I said, yes. Can DILG impose penalty? No. Only the municipal council. Only the city council. You better buy my book, Kapitan. You better buy my book. Bumili. Bumili ng 30 ang Kapitan. Nagkaroon tuloy ako ng maraming pera. So, if you want, you buy books on katarungang pambarangay law. No? So, it is the city council or as a whole who can suspend the barangay captain, no? If he is biased in deciding cases. So, remember, future compañeros, that the maximum is only 60 days because the prescriptive period and that will suspend the prescriptive period of whatever offenses, it is only 60. But because of this pandemic, it will be considered as an act of God or fortuitous event. Therefore, it can be extended. So, remember that, compañeros, future compañeros and compañeras. You know, every time that I lectured, there are so many lawyers who are number one in the bar. Suma magrakbat, they tried to scare me, but I don't care, no? I told them that, yeah, whatever questions you ask, actual cases, you know, they ask actual cases. Because I told them that I'm a lecturer on the Supreme Court. I lecture judges, justices, how much you? So I lecture the judges, justices, prosecutors, lawyers. I reach already. Top, no? That is why nakuha ko na lahat. That is why I wrote so many books. No? And that the National Book Development Board asked me, Judge, how many books? Because I'm now a book owner. No? Palo Bookstore. I am now a bookstore. Judge, how many books you will write within 1 year? Sabi ko, 20 books. I will write 20 books. 20 books. if I can write even up to 50 books. So I always write books now. Now, oh, but this is my book on international law. I will include the International Criminal Court, because if it is an International Criminal Court book, that I will include in my international law book, that is the first book that I've written by an international lawyer, Judge Pampilo, no? Of International Criminal Court. Yeah, because of the prosecutor of the International Criminal Court wanted to investigate and file a case against Duterte because of this Dragon War. Then, di pangkat, shall convene not later than 3 days from its constitution. So, yung pangkat, we call it pangkat na tapakasundo, will convene after 3 days. They will choose who is the chairman and who is the secretary. Then, they will summons and send subpoena. So, one lawyers asked me, can barangay official Lupunta Pamayapa issue subpoena? Can police officer NBI issue subpoena? I said, yes. Although the local government code, the Katurang Pamagray law, the Presidential Decree number 1508 did not specify the word subpoena, but it said that it can issue summons, notices to the parties to appear in the barangay district. I said, yes, because they performs quasi-judicial functions. And said, can police officer may issue a subpoena? Yes, under the PNP manual, they are allowed to issue subpoena. How about NBI? Yes, under the NBI manual, they are allowed to issue a subpoena. How much more the barangay official, the Lupung Tapamayapa, Pangkat Tapasundo, because they are considered as performing quasi-judicial functions. No? So, the decision of the Pangkat Tapasundo will be majority. No? Majority. Okay. So, that is Pangkat Tapasundo. The majority vote will be, I will discuss last one, topic. Period to arrive is settlement. The pangkat shall arrive is settlement or resolution the dispute within 15 days period. No? So, you know, if there is already a settlement or a resolution, I always inform the Liga ng mga barangay, pangkat na tapakasundo and Lupo Tapamayapa, that you must enforce and execute your decision. Why? If you fail to enforce and execute your decision, your settlement, then after 6 months, it could no longer be enforced. You have to go to court and file an initiatory pleadings in court, a petition. Can you imagine that? Instead of settling the case amicably, it will go back to the court, to MTC, because you are remiss in your duty to enforce the writ of execution within 6 months. Because after 6 months, you have to go to courts. So, that will be the end of my lectures, although sumubra ako ng minuto. Okay, future compañeros, compañeras, I hope that I was able to discuss extensively the law on Katarungang Pambarangay, wherein it is useful to you in a barangay dispute, especially your relatives, your friends, will ask questions about the Katarungang Pamaraylo. Remember that Lawyers are not allowed to appear in any hearing in the barangay dispute. It is absolute. It is absolute. Okay, thank you, future compañeros, compañeras. See you again on my next lecture. I always lectured almost every day. But the administrator of the pre-online law schools of the Philippines nagging me that, Judge, please give us another time that you will lecture. Although I'm very, very tired, but I can give you my best lecture. No bragging. Every time that I lectured, I'm standing ovation. I'm the only lecturer who got an standing ovation by the lawyers, judges, prosecutors, law professors. Okay, thank you very much. If you want, you can buy my book, The Katarong Pamangaray Law 2021 edition, The Legal Ethics. You can use it in your bar examination, and that a guide in Dangerous Drugs Act. Next month, I will release my book on remedial law with 2019 rules on civil procedure. I will also release my book on political law, international law, and in international court, criminal court. Okay, thank you. Good night, future compañeros, compañeras. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Mabuhay. Mami.
Pinilis mo na?